Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Amma ba'da habita fillah. From the usool of Islam is the importance of ikhlas, sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That if we go back to that, not just as far as our practice of course is the most important thing, but as far as our understanding, that will clear many masail, many issues that you confront in understanding the deen. You will be able to understand the issues better. That from amongst the means, the conditions for us to have our deeds accepted by Allah Azza wa Jal is that we have sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ikhlas lillah. And the other condition is that what we do is in accordance with the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So ikhlas wa sunnah are the conditions for your deeds to be accepted. What this means, ayyuha muhabba, is that when you pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that your heart must be attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It must be sincere, sincerely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Purity, purity in ibadah. And that the act of ibadah must be in accordance with the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Innama a'malu bin niyat." Verily actions are tied to the intention. "Wa innama li kulli imrin manawa." And everyone will get that for which he intended. "وَمَنْ كَانَتْ وَإِنَّمَا لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مَا نَوَى فَمَنْ كَانَتْ حِجَّتُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ فَحِجَّتُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ." And whoever makes hijra to Allah and His Messenger, then he's made hijra to Allah and His Messenger. You know, that shows you your intention. Your actions are tied to that intention. "وَمَنْ كَانَتْ حِجَّتُهُ لِلدُّنْيَا يُصِيبَهَا أَوْ امْرَأَةٍ يَنْكِحُهَا فَهِجْرَتُهُ إِلَى مَا هَاجَرَ إِلَيْهِ." The Prophet ﷺ said, and whoever makes hijrah for something of this worldly life, or to take some woman in marriage, then he will get that for which he intended. Meaning that his reward is tied to his intention. So that is evidence from the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ on the importance of ikhlas. And Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said, قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد. Whoever innovates in this religion of ours will have it rejected. And that shows us that it's not sufficient just to have sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just to have the ikhlas, but that it has to be in accordance with the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that whatever act that we're doing of ibadah must be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and in accordance with how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did that act of ibadah. And if we practice that, those two principles will have success in this life as well as the hereafter, because that is the asl of our deen. That is the origin of our religion, where our religion returns back to. That's where your ibadah goes back to. Those two conditions. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil and bless us with ikhlas. Wa thabat ala sunnah. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.